Iron Rattler, the second ever RMC hybrid coaster to be built in the world, being located at Six Flags Fiesta Texas, is one of the best coasters in the world. Yes, I said it, Iron Rattler is for sure one of the best coasters you will ever get to experience, and that statement comes with a lot of great reasoning. From the top-notch outstanding elements such as one of the best drops in the world, a fantastic zero-G roll, and of course the dive off the quarry wall, Iron Rattler packs in one of the best rides out there. Made by RMC, this is one of their best creations. Even if it was their second ever hybrid they built, that just shows you on how incredible of a manufacturer they are. Though it may not be the longest ride out there, it sure packs a huge punch, so that is of course what I'll be doing in today's video, my full in-depth review on Iron Rattler located at Six Flags Fiesta Texas. But most importantly, before we start, if you're new to the channel, make sure to like, comment, and subscribe for more videos on coasters often, as it really helps the channel out tremendously doing all three of those things, especially liking the video. Also, if you want to see more, make sure to follow my Instagram for updates and much more. But now that is out of the way, let's jump in to this review. As to start off, I have ridden this coaster a great amount of times. From 2016, 17, 19, and 20, every visit, this thing has ran incredible, and I am glad to say that I have ridden it so many times, though I don't know the exact amount, all of the important rows I have pretty much experienced. But without a doubt, the best time to ride this coaster is at night, backseat, lots of room, and with it being pitch black through the layout, this is a fantastic experience. This past summer, I even got fireworks on the last ride of the night that was truly one of the best experiences I have ever gotten on a coaster that just shows you on how insane this coaster can be. Really, the stats are also pretty impressive. I mean, the height is 179 feet, it's 70 miles per hour, 3,266 feet long, it has an inversion, and all of those are great stats. Due to the stats, it leads to all of those fantastic elements such as the main drop, zero G roll, and of course the dive off the quarry wall. These elements are what makes Iron Rattler how good it is. Even though the other elements are solid, this is the main part of the coaster. Personally, my favorite is that first drop, which by first look, you may assume the dive off the quarry wall is the best part, which I could see that, but for me, it is that crazy, insane drop. No question, this drop is the best in Texas, one of the best in the world. I'm even convinced that this could be the best drop to exist on this planet. And no, I am not overstating that. Specifically, in the back, you will experience some of the most crazy and sustained airtime out there, even with the laterals packed into it. It goes right along that quarry wall, which adds to the incredible looking nature of this coaster. The angle of descent is 91 degrees, which is so steep, and even it's twisted, which is just breathtaking. You have to experience it to realize how incredible it is, on the same as with the dive off the quarry wall, which executes the same outstanding airtime. It will leave you speechless, but only if you ride it in the back, as that is by far the best row of this coaster, there's really no question to that. Of course, in the back you get pulled over those airtime hills. These trains are actually like super long, which of course results in you getting thrown out of your seat even more. As with any other RMC, this coaster is absolutely glossy smooth, and not like a normal RMC, this is one of the smoothest ones, on level with Twisted Timbers and especially Scale Vengeance. It's so perfectly smooth, butter smooth, whatever you want to call it, as you feel like you are just gliding along that very good looking orange track. I think this orange track looks super good, just like it does on Wicked Cyclone and Medusa. This coaster is like super appealing. I mean, it towers over, of course, that quarry wall. The presentation of this coaster is fantastic, and that leads to the very original layout of this coaster climbing up and diving off that quarry wall multiple times. You can't find this on any other ride, which just makes the layout more and more unique, even if it has its downsides. Really, it's not that big of a downside, but it would be that this coaster loses some of the speed when in the top, which is of course bound to happen. I actually think this coaster delivers with some great elements on the top, like those airtime hills, the super cool outer banked, really tight turns, and all of that leads to, of course, that dive off the quarry wall, another super cool element to look at, the same with this cool Iron Rattler logo on the side of the structure. It's a neat touch to the presentation, as let's walk up to this coaster. Right in front of you is that main plaza, as you will notice those two cool looking snakes. There is not that much to this area other than the sign, pretty much with all the theming throughout the ride, as it kinda is like a western, like kinda snake theme. It's pretty loose in the theming, but you will notice a little, such as the snakes, a car, some cool signs, and some more small details throughout the queue. Both of that and this station is pretty basic. You can definitely see that it was carried over from the original Rattler, nothing, you know, too special at all. As you enter this station, greeting you are these super cool and nice trains, but the not so good thing is that they will most of the time be only running one train, which for re-rides is super frustrating. Though the ride is pretty short, it for sure slows down the operations, as really they are not the best or worst in their dispatches. What's really cool is that from the station and exit, you can see the coaster from far away, as it gives some great view of that layout, especially the drop. This just gives you the perspective on how far away the rest of the coaster is, as you will enter those snake-themed trains, as the front of this train is super cool with, of course, that snake head. The whole train looks like a snake, but man, these restraints as you board the coaster, you'll just realize on how comfy they are. They are made by Gerstlauer, but the main pro is that if you get some decent room, they don't come down during the ride, which can result in some crazy airtime. Normally, especially on the RMC trains, they can come down during the ride, but the only way these come down is that if you push it down yourself, a huge factor in why this ride is so good. The ride-offs do tend to staple, so I definitely recommend pushing up without them noticing, and as a result, you will get a fantastic ride. Just before you leave the station, there's of course one of the best station voiceovers leading to you departing that station. There is a little straight track just to begin your ride, as you will turn down and go up into that big lift hill, as this delivers some absolutely fantastic views of the whole park. You go up it decently fast as you finally arrive at the top of the lift hill, where if you have ridden this coaster prior to 2020, there used to be a major slowdown. That was actually due to a malfunction, which was pretty cool when it lasted, but now it just goes right over the top at normal speed, leading to that drop. As I went over earlier, there really is nothing else to say about this incredible drop. I mean, it has the airtime, the laterals, that view, and of course, that makes it so good, the way it twists down the quarry wall. It is the definition of a world-class drop, as quickly after you will shoot through that tunnel and speed up right into the quarry wall, delivering a solid pop of airtime. You will experience a banked turn right after a super fun element, really the only on top of the quarry wall this go around. Traveling back down, you will do a twisted dive right into the super good zero G roll. This is by far one of the best inversions RMC has ever included on one of their coasters. You get a great feeling of out of control, but it's almost graceful in the way you come up and flow through that fantastic element. Being out of your seat is another characteristic of this inversion, as you feel some great weightlessness maneuvering into a sudden, another quality airtime hill. And the pacing does not affect this, or any of the other elements during this section, as you will be flying out of your seat, which just shows you on how this coaster packs in so many great elements. The pacing is actually good, a huge way to show that this coaster really has like no downsides than maybe the length, which is not the worst thing at all. There is a banked turn followed by a tiny outer banked turn, and just any way you ride it, it's just so fun on how it just flows through it. A quick hill will come, and then of course that dive off the quarry wall, as you can see, even get a quick glance of another great view overlooking the whole park. You are falling forever, it feels like, right by the little section of water transitioning into the rock through the quarry, and this is a super cool segment. It is short but sweet, but not for long, as you will finally get thrown out of your seat on one last airtime hill, declining into the brake run. It really is unfortunate when this ride ends, but that just shows you on how unbelievable this experience is from start to finish. This is without a doubt the best coaster in the state of Texas and provides Fiesta Texas a great number one coaster. So we have to get to the overall score, and what will I be giving Iron Rattler? Of course, I'll be giving this coaster a 10 out of 10, and I have no doubt in my mind that it deserves that score, because this is one of the best coasters in the world. So, what do you think of Iron Rattler? Make sure to post that in the comments below. I'll read every comment. Love what you guys have to say. And of course, if you are not already, make sure to like, comment, and subscribe for more videos on coasters often. And see ya!